of following numbers. GCD means HCF, highest common factor or greatest common divisor. Say, okay. So see, here we have to find GCD of the given two numbers. For this, we are going to use prime factorization method. Which method? Prime factorization method. Now, there are so many methods like prime factorization method, short division method, long division method to find HCF and LCM. Already in 4th standard, we have learned this. So, when I will explain you, you will come to know. Okay? So, see. Find the GCD of following numbers. 12. Find the GCD of following numbers. 12 and 18. So, here we have to find greatest common divisor of 12 and 18. Okay, so which method we are going to use to find GCD here? Prime factorization method. Now see, prime factorization. If you remember, we have learned to find prime factors of the given number. Do you remember? I have given one video of that lecture, prime factors, right? So we have learned to find prime factors. Same, first we have to find prime factors of 12, then we have to find prime factors of 18. Okay, and for the next steps, I'll show you. So first, we need to find prime factors of 12. And when we find prime factors, what we do? Yes, we write number this way. Now we know we have prime numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, and so on. Okay, now see. First, we will check 12 is divisible by which prime number? Is it divisible by our first prime number 2? Yes. Now, here to check whether it is divisible by these prime numbers, we need to use divisibility test. Okay. So, last digit of 12 is 2, that means it is divisible by 2. So, write 2 here, 12 divided by 2. 2, 6 are 12. 2, 6 are 12. Okay. Then, again, check 6 is divisible by our first number. Is 6 divisible by our first number, our first prime number 2? Yes. 2, 3 is 6. And 3 is divisible by which prime number? 3 is prime number itself, so it is divisible by itself. 3, 1 is 3. Finish. So these are the prime factors of 12. Then find prime factors of 18. Again, 18, is 18 divisible by our first prime number? Yes. As last digit is 8, it is divisible by 2. 2, 9s are 18, okay? Then 9 is divisible by which prime number? Is it divisible by our first prime number 2? No. It is divisible by 3. 3, 3s are 9 and 3, 1s are 3, okay? So here, the first step we have completed, we have found prime factors of both the numbers, prime factors of 12 and prime factors of 18. Now the next step, please pay attention carefully or see the steps and understand it. See, here we have found prime factors of 12, write 12 here and is equal to, 12 is equal to, write all prime factors. Whenever we write prime factors, if you remember, whenever we write prime factors, write them in the form of multiplication. That is 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, so these are the prime factors of 12. After that, here below 12, write prime factors of 18. So prime factors of 18 are 2 into 3 into 3. So 2 into 3 into 3. Okay, understood second step. First we found prime factors in this way and then we wrote prime factors of both the numbers in this way. The next step is very important. See, what we have to do in this prime factors of 12 and 18, which are common prime factors. Now common means, you know common means what? The factor of this also, prime factors of 12 also, prime factors of 18 also, it should be. So see, this 2 and 2 is common, 2 and 2 is common. So, we will circle it, maybe circle it, okay. Then which is common? This 2 and 3, are these common? No. 3 and 3 are common. 3 is here also, 3 is in this also. So take it common. Understood this step? We have taken common factor. We have circled common factor. Okay. Now, GCD. GCD. Of 12 and 15 is equal to GCD of 12 and 15 is means what? Multiplication of common factors. Multiplication of common factors. In according to this method, what we have to do? We have to multiply common factors. Only multiplication of common factors. Right? Multiplication of common factors. Okay, multiplication of common factors. So which are common factors here? Common prime factors 2 and 3. Now see, we have circled this 2, this 2 and this 2. We have to take it only one time. 2. Which this is one common factor 2 and this is second another common factor 3. So 2 into 3. That is 6. So our answer is 6. 6 is the highest common factor or greatest common divisor of 12 and 18. Now you can check by see 6 is 6 is means 12 and 18 is divisible by 6, right? And it is the highest. More than 6 or greater than 6, there is not a number which is greater than 6 by which this 12 and 18 are divisible. Okay, there is no other greater number. 6 is the greater number or greater common divisor of greatest common divisor of 12 and 18. Understood? So this is the prime factorization method, and this we are going to use to find GCD as well as LCM also. Okay, for LCM also same method we are going to use. Just there is little change here that I will tell you while finding LCM. Now see, let's find the HCF or GCD of 36 and 48. Same procedure we have to do. First find prime factors of 36. Now see, 36 last digit is 6, that means it is divisible by 2. 36 divided by 2, what else we will get? 36 divided by 2. If orally you are not able to find, then divide it. 2 ones are 2. 2 is 16. What we are getting? 18 2 is 36. So 36 divided by 2 is 18. Okay. Further, 18 is divisible by, see now, 18. Prime factors of 18 are here. 2 9 is 18. 3 is 9. And 3 1 is 3. Finish. So these are the prime factors of 36. Let's find prime factors of 48. Now see, 48 is again last digit is 8, that means it is divisible by our first prime number 2. So let's divide 48 by 2. What answer do we get? 48 divided by 2? 2, 2's are 4, 2, 4's are 8. 24. 24, 2's are 48, okay? Further, 24 is 24 divisible by 2? Yes. 2, 1's are 2, 2, 2's are 4. 12. Now prime factors of 12 are here. 2, 6 are 12, 2, 3 are 6, 3, 1 are 3. Finish. First step over, we have found prime factors of 36 and 48. Okay. Now see, right here prime factors of 36 are 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. And prime factors of 48 are 2 into 2 into. Now see, These two we have written here, these two we have written here. Okay, now see upside, if you have seen in this first example, we have taken common factors, so we have to take common factors later. So what we are going to do, you know, upside there is 3, right? So what we will do in this prime factors of 48, is there 3? Yes, see this. So this 3 will write below this divide. Then it is easy to take common factors. It becomes easy to take common factors. Okay. So these 3 we have written. We can change the order of numbers in the multiplication. Okay. So this 3 we have taken first. After that, is there one more 3? No. So remaining 2, we can write. This arrangement we have done. Order of numbers we have changed in the multiplication. Okay. It's okay. Now a common factor, common prime factors. See, this two and this two is common, so we will circle it. This two and this two common. It's not circle, it is box. We will say this 3 and this 3 is common. Okay, so this 3, 2, they are not common. So common prime factors we have circled. Now you know GCD means what? GCD of 36 and 48 is equal to what? Multiplication of common factor or product of common factor. Product. That is, which are common factors here? Common prime factors 2, 2 and 3. Okay, 2 into 2 into 3, that is 3 to the 6 6 to the 12. So GCD, greatest common divisor, GCD of 36 and 48 is 12. 12 is the highest common factor or divisor of 36 and 48. Okay, see, 12 3 is 36 12 4 is 48. Both numbers are divisible by 12. There is no greater number than 12 by which 36 and 48 is divisible. 12 is only the highest. Okay. And third one example we will see. 96 and 120. As we are going to find GCD using prime factorization method, so first we need to find prime factors of both the numbers. So prime factors of 96, is 96 divisible by 2? Yes, last digit is 6, that means it is divisible. So divide 96 by 2. 2 4s are 8. 2 8s are 16. Answer is 48. Okay? 48 2s are 96. There. 48 is divisible by, now see, be smart sometime. 48 C. Here we have to find prime factors of 48, and in this first example we have already found it. So let's write as it is. 2 24 is 48, 2 12 is 24, 2 6 is 12, 2 3 is 6, and 3 1 is 3. Okay. So these are the prime factors of 96. Then let's find prime factors of 120. Again, 120 is divisible by 12 because last digit is 0. Okay? So see, 120 divided by 2. 2 6 is 12 and 2 0 is 0, 60. Again, 60 is also divisible by 2. 2 3 is 6, 2 0 is 0. 32 is 60. Then 30 is also divisible by 2. 2 15 is 15, 2 is 30. And 15 is divisible by, is 15 divisible by 2? No. The next prime number is 3. So check whether 15 is divisible by 3, 5 plus 1, 6, yes, 6 is there in the table of 3, that means 15 is divisible by 3, 3, 5 are 15, and 5 is divisible by 5 itself, because it is prime number, okay, 5 is 5. So here are the prime factors of 96 and 120. Now, let us write prime factors of 96, 2 into 2 into into 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, then prime factors of 120.
20. 2 into this 2 into this 2 into this 3. Now see, there is 3 and we are in the prime factors of 96, 3 is here. Okay, so one change you can do, these 3 will write here and these 2 will write here. Okay, and these 3 right below this 3, and there is 5. There is no 5 in the prime factors of 96. Now take common factors. Make box to the common factors. 2 and 2, 2 and 2. 2 and 2. And 3 and 3. See, sometimes what students do, they take common factors, you know. Factors of 96 only means these 2 and these 2, they will take common. No. Common means the factor should be the factor of 96 and 120. Understood? In this way only you have to take common factors. Now, GCD of 96 and 120 is. Now, all that I did not write multiplication of common factors. Once you understand, then you can directly write here. GCD of 96 and 120 is. You know, GCD means multiplication of common divisors, common factors, okay? So, which are common here? 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Right? 2, 2, 2 and 3. So 3 to the 6, 6 to the 12, 12 to the 24. 24 is the GCD of 96 and 120. Understood? So these 3 examples of GCD we have solved today. So hope you have understood this. If you have any problem regarding with this, ask me, watch the video twice. If you once you not understand, then watch video twice. And even if you have any problem, you're free to ask. Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.